Today I'm going to explain who the devil Lucifugus is, who was conjured by Nacht and who killed his entire family including his brother Morgen. I will show you the role Lucifugus plays in Black Clover, his relationship with Lucifero, the Clippeth, and what his position is in the entire underworld. I will also explain why Zenon's devil is Beelzebub and why there is a possibility that Julius Novachrono is possessed by one of the leaders of Hell, the time magic devil Astaroth, but still may not be evil. Black Clover Chapter 286 Review here on Yunami. Before we start, when I mention Lucifer, I'm talking about the demon in demonology, and when I say Lucifero, I am talking about the devil in Black Clover. The same goes for Lucifuge, the demon in demonology, and Lucifugus, the devil that Nacht conjured in Black Clover. Black Clover Chapter 286 begins with the backstory of Nacht. We found out that Nacht has always been doing bad things since he was young. He only did what he thought was fun. While Morgen was the opposite, he was a guy like Light with the same magical attribute. That means that Morgen has light magic. And those who have already read the chapter knows that Nacht conjured a devil named Lucifugus. The name may be different in the official translation, but it is safe to say that the name is definitely a reference to the demon Lucifuge Refoco, one of the highest demons in demonology. I'm going to talk about this devil in detail in a moment. I have some very interesting things to show. However, here's something very interesting about the name. Lucifer, who was used as a reference for the devil Lucifero, has a full name, which is Lucifer Morningstar, the bringer of light. And the German name for morning is Morgen, the name of Nacht's brother. And as we found out in this chapter, Morgen, like the name description of Lucifer Morningstar, the light bringer, has light magic. But that's not everything. So if Lucifer means bringer of light, on the other hand, Lucifuge is the literary opposite. The name comes from two Latin words, which is light and flee. So together, he who seeks refuge from light or he who flees from the light. In demonology, Lucifuge is related to the living darkness and is said to be connected to Lucifer. Lucifuge has also a full name, which is Lucifuge Refocal. The name is derived from the name Lucifer, reversed Reficul, and further Latinized Refocal. So not only are Lucifer and Lucifugus very close personally, which I will explain later in this video, but their names also show a close relationship and their attributes are the opposite. Just like the Faust twins, with Nacht having shadow magic, which is the characteristic of Lucifuge, and Morgen light magic that fits the description of Lucifer, the Lightbringer. This connection becomes more clear with the symbolism that Tabata used in Black Clover Chapter 286, when Lucifugus was summoned and attacked everyone but the one who summoned him, Nacht with shadow magic. But Morgen was the only one who could stop the ritual using light magic, because Lucifugus' natural enemy is light magic, exactly as described in demonology. We will talk about Lucifugus in a moment. We found out that when Yami and Nacht were young, they were actually good friends, if not even best friends, who did bad things together, basically troublemakers. Yami and Nacht's brother Morgen later joined the magic knight squad the Great Deer, in which Julius Novachrono was captain. It seems like Nacht is slowly getting jealous that his brother was taking his best friend away from him, and he didn't like how Yami started to change. Maybe this is one of the reasons why Nacht started to dislike the Magic Knights, and maybe this is one of the reasons why he started to dislike Yami as well, because Yami stopped hanging out with him. When Nacht turned 18, he was named the next head of the House Faust. Nacht didn't understand why he was chosen and not Morgen. His father told him that using his shadow magic he can do an invitation to the Dark Garden, which is a big part of demonology, and allow him to enter the shadow place where all devil binding rituals are performed. The House Faust has dedicated itself to demonology for generations. The core of the family tradition was passed on to Nacht, which is shadow magic. Nacht was very surprised to find out that his shadow magic is more benefiting than light magic for his family. The temptation of this unknown danger made him excited. He liked the fact that in the Faust family, he was the normal and Morgen the weird. With time, Morgen and Yami became powerful magic knights, while Nacht was engaged in demonology. He managed to summon and bind four devils, most likely the devils we already know. Nacht's father believes that Nacht is a genius and is able to bind that devil. Here it is important to understand that devil does not refer to the highest devil possible, because that devil may simply be personally the most important devil for the House Faust. Mainly because in demonology it is said that one cannot bind one of the three highest devils with a ritual in which the human is in control. Now we are going to talk about the devil Lucifugus himself. We found out that the devil Lucifugus, whom Nacht has called, is the pillar that supports the three rulers of the underworld. the devils with time, space, and gravity magic. I know with time magic we all immediately think of Julius Novachrono, and we will talk about this in a moment. The reason why Lucifugus is so important and considered the pillar of the highest ranking devils is that in demonology, Lucifuge is the demon who is in charge of the government of hell, on the order of Lucifer. It should be noted here that although Lucifer is the official leader of hell, with the true ruler of hell being Satan. Because after the war in heaven, God banished all rebelling angels so that they fell from heaven to hell, giving them the name fallen angels. Later with time they became demons and devils. The only one sent to the lowest place in hell where no light can reach him was Satan, which makes him unable to communicate with anyone in hell, heaven or earth. This is why Lucifer is considered to be the leader, but the real king is always Satan. And with the new revelation that the demon Lucifer from demonology exists in Black Clover as the devil Lucifugus, makes the fact that Satan exists practically undeniable. This means that the creation of the Clippeth and the final gate does not release the greatest threat in Black Clover. This will be a much more powerful devil named Satan, whom the devils have yet to set free. And because of the existence of Lucifuge, the existence of angels is now undeniable as well, especially considering how often the term God has been used lately. But for now, back to the chapter. The three rulers mentioned in Black Clover are most likely the three devils behind the final gate of the Clippeth ritual. And although there are many versions in demonology of who these three devils could be, in connection with Lucifuge, there are always only the same three demons mentioned. These are Lucifer, Beelzebub, and Astaroth. Anyone who has been watching our videos for some time should know that we have always believed that Zenon's devil has a very good chance of being Beelzebub. And with this new information according to the mentioned magic, it is really possible that Zenon's devil could be one of the three devils' leaders with spatial magic. Lucifero, the leader with gravitation magic, and the last one who is still unknown but according to demonology, should be Astaroth with time magic. Of course, Zenon could also have Astaroth instead of Beelzebub, but according to Astaroth's description as one who knows the past and the future, the time magic just fits perfect. But I will do more research on this for a future video that will be released soon. And I know what you're thinking about. How many times have I made a video about Julius Novachrono that he is extremely sus and could possibly even be a devil user? And with the new information that there's indeed a devil leader using time magic, it's obvious that now suddenly everyone is jumping on the train and theorizing that Julius is evil or possessed by the time devil. We have already covered this topic, but now with the new information, I can do more research. This will make my upcoming videos much more accurate than what we have said about Julius so far. Nevertheless, most of what we have already mentioned about Julius is still important and valid, especially if Astaroth is really one of the three ruling devils and also has time magic, because time magic fits Astaroth's description best. And if Julius is really possessed by Astaroth, he might not even be evil, because in demonology, Astaroth is described as more or less good. So this will again fit to the video we published yesterday. I will probably make a video on this subject on Wednesday. If you already need some information, be sure to check out this video that I posted just yesterday. It's really, really good, and it will definitely have a second part. I'm going to be posting really cool videos next week, so if you don't want to miss out on all the new videos, subscribe and turn on the notification bell so that you will be notified when we post a new video. Otherwise, YouTube won't show you our videos. Back to the Black Clover chapter 286. When Nacht tried to summon Lucifugus, Morgen suddenly appeared and tried to stop his brother Nacht. Morgen tells his family that the things they do are bad, and as a magic knight, he cannot overlook such a crime. Nevertheless, Nacht put on the relic to conjure up Lucifugus and said, "Right here and now I will surpass my limits." These words were the cause of the dramatic events that will occur in a moment, and therefore, the reason why Nacht hates the sentence so much, and maybe even partly the reason he hates Yami, since Yami influenced Nacht a lot when they were younger. Lucifugus was summoned, but in the end, he was far more powerful than the Faust family imagined, and Lucifugus attacked everyone apart the one who summoned him. But then, suddenly, Morgen came and cancelled the ritual by destroying the relic with light magic. This also corresponds to the meaning of the name and description of Lucifuge in demonology, as light is the only magic he fears. The ritual was stopped and the relic and Lucifugus disintegrated. Before Morgen died, he told his brother Nacht about his dream. He wanted to be next to his older brother, the shadow and light magic knights to protect the peace of the Clover Kingdom. Then, Nacht shouted that God should save his brother in exchange for his own life. We know that Nacht mentioned God before. In fact, Nacht is the only character in this series that has mentioned God in such a context. This is also a topic for a future video. I hope you enjoyed this review. If you like our content, please feel free to subscribe to our channel, like this video and comment on what you think of this review, and share this video with your friends. And most importantly, turn on the notification bell. This is the best way to support us, as you can watch all of our videos. Thank you for watching. I wish you a wonderful morning, day or night, wherever you live, and see you next time. Bye.